Once upon a time, there was an era where Call of Duty games were amazing. Call of Duty 4, World at War, Call of Duty Black Ops, Modern Warfare 3, each year a Call of Duty game released, the community was so excited to get their hands on it. And at the same time, the Nintendo Wii was outselling both the Xbox 360 and the PS3. So Activision came around after a year or two and realized, you know what would be a great idea? Let's put this stuff on the Nintendo Wii and make even more money. I'm not gonna lie and say that Activision decided to do something for the greater good of the Call of Duty community. They're always been money driven and they always will, but because of the Wii's success, Call of Duty Black Ops, Modern Warfare 3, and a couple other Call of Duty games made their way onto the Nintendo Wii. And despite the motion controls or whatever, at the core, these were solid Call of Duty games that might have had worse graphics or less control sensitivity and maybe some features were cut out, but as new releases came out, the games became closer and closer aligned with the core game series that the people on the Xbox 360, PC, and PS3 were getting. And for Nintendo fans, things are looking pretty good. Even if you didn't have an Xbox 360 or PS3, you could still experience Call of Duty, which was a huge deal at the time. And then Call of Duty Ghosts came out on the Nintendo Wii U, and we all know that the Nintendo Wii U wasn't that much of a success. And I mean, Call of Duty Ghosts already had sales that were down, but the Wii U didn't let Activision make its return on investment. And that would be it for Call of Duty coming out on Nintendo consoles as of today. However, things might actually be changing finally with Call of Duty Black Ops 4. Despite the failure that the Wii U was as far as Activision was concerned, Activision might finally have its eye on the Nintendo Switch because, honestly, the Switch is selling pretty well right now. And we know Activision is trying really hard to make Call of Duty Black Ops 4's Blackout mode be the new Battle Royale game that everyone's playing. And Fortnite, Call of Duty's competition here, is already on the Nintendo Switch. So is it possible that Call of Duty Black Ops 4 could finally be released on Nintendo Switch? Well, for the first time we have somewhat of a definitive answer. In a recent interview with Game Informer, our Call of Duty daddy David Vonderhaar went ahead and said that they are looking into the possibility of Call of Duty Black Ops 4 coming on the Nintendo Switch. This is no confirmation by any means, however, this is the closest we've come to having some sort of idea that maybe it's time Call of Duty comes back. As far as the technological aspects of Call of Duty are concerned, we know that the Nintendo Switch has at least the capabilities of last-gen consoles, but with the accessibility of having them portable. And if you look at Treyarch's track record with Call of Duty, they were technically the last Call of Duty game that was put on the older last generation system of consoles. Black Ops 3 was released on the Xbox 360 and PS3. So we know that it's not crazy for Treyarch to work on different versions of the game at the same time during development. And if you remember correctly, the Nintendo Switch isn't really having any problem running games like Doom or Wolfenstein just at a lower graphical quality. And while we might not be seeing Nintendo Switch get Call of Duty Black Ops 4 at release, it's very unlikely that would happen. We wouldn't be too surprised to see Call of Duty Black Ops 4 be put onto Nintendo Switch sometime early next year, maybe around March or so. And if Call of Duty is in fact trying to make Blackout this new definitive Battle Royale game that's gonna last years, which David Vonderhaar also said during the same interview, maybe it is time to put Call of Duty back on Nintendo Switch and get it running on every console possible to try to compete with some of these huge, larger Battle Royale games like Fortnite. Our only hope is Activision doesn't try to pull any of the stuff they used to pull in the earlier days of porting Call of Duty onto things like the Nintendo DS and the Nintendo Wii. If they're going to port the game onto Nintendo Switch, it needs to be the full game. Lower graphics are fine, we don't care about that if the gameplay is tight, which means all features need to be included. If the game comes out on the Nintendo Switch, it needs to have the full blackout mode. Even if it's locked to just Switch players, that's okay. It needs to have zombies mode, and it also needs to have the full multiplayer with the DLC, as far as I'm concerned, to make it worth being purchased. I'm ready to make the jump and get Call of Duty on the Nintendo Switch. However, those are just kind of the necessary things for me to choose not to buy the game on the PC or the Xbox. I don't have a PlayStation 4 yet. And go ahead and get it on Nintendo Switch because I love the portability function. Being able to play the Switch in bed, Call of Duty before I go to bed, awesome. I might not be able to trash talk because Nintendo's online system looks like a hot mess, but that's a debate for a different day. But what do you think? Would you pick up Call of Duty for Nintendo Switch? If you're a Nintendo Switch owner, do you want Call of Duty to even come out on the Nintendo Switch? Let us know what you think in the comment section down below. If you're new, be sure to subscribe and turn the notifications on because YouTube's just trash at telling people when our videos are up, and if you hit the bell, apparently it works a little bit better. Alright guys, that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you all later. Bye-bye.